nearby. I'm sure you're very anxious to get out on track. It's taken a lot of effort to get to F1. Congratulations. But the real work starts now. This is...
Claire, motorsports journalist. Nice to meet you. You'll be seeing quite a lot of me throughout the season. So, you had a pretty impressive junior career. How are you feeling about your move into F1? Do you think you have what it takes?
Let's save the questions for a proper interview, shall we? I'm sure you'll have a lot more to talk about once there's been some action on track. I think we could fit you in after FP1 if you're free.
That works for me. I'll grab you the second you finish on the track.
Remember, the relationship you have with the team can be affected by what you say to the media. So be careful. Anyway, it's time to catch up with Carl. He's waiting for you in the data center. Good luck out there today.
Welcome to the data center. Here, we've got access to all kinds of information, including car telemetry, weather, lap times, tire wear, the list goes on. Plus, we've got a direct link back to the factory, so we're in constant communication with the team there. We need you to regularly feedback about areas of the car that are lacking and help us direct our resources in the most productive way. More effort here equals a quicker car, so it's well worth the effort. Good luck this season. Oh, and make us all look good, okay?
Here you can see the pertinent details about your current contract. On one side are the objectives and bonuses that we've negotiated with the team. On the other is information regarding how you're perceived throughout the paddock, your reputation with the current team, and your overall value to them, which is a combination of these elements. Winning rivalries is a great way to earn respect from your team and around the paddock, which will help make it easier to negotiate favorable contracts. Your first rival is always your teammate, but you can choose who to declare as your second. The harder the rival from the eligible selection, the more respect you stand to gain or lose, depending on the result.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. It's been a lot of hard work, but here you are making your debut in Formula One. You must be thrilled. So how are you finding things at the team? Are you settling in? What are you expecting out of this season? Are you just aiming to find your feet in Formula One, or do you see something more? Great! Well, that's everything.
Welcome to your new team. Haas are experts in getting great value out of every investment. That's why they skipped being backmarkers and jumped straight into the midfield pack in their first season. You are now one of those investments. Make sure they get plenty of value, okay?
Okay, decent lap there, but there's still more to find. Keep at it.
Thank you.
across the sixth row of the grid.
Kevin.
Be careful with the front wing. You've taken some minor damage.
Kevin.
1 minute remaining, just 1 minute. Well done.
So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Bottas, Ricciardo and Kimi Raikkonen. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
Well done. That was a good qualifying performance.
New drivers, new cars, and a new Formula One season. But it's the same Albert Park that we've come to know and love for more than two decades now that hosts the first round of a 21 race championship, taking us from here in Melbourne, Australia, across the globe, before we eventually reach the season finale at Yas Marina Circuit in Abu Dhabi. Here's the track then, 16 corners, 6 to the left and 10 to the right. They make up the 3.3 miles around Albert Park Lake, with turn 1 and 3 providing the best opportunities to pass. We have plenty of changes to the sport this year, with the addition of new safety features, the return of France and Germany in an expanded 21 race calendar, and more tyre compounds than ever before. And of course, we have some big car manufacturers back in the sport too, with Alfa Romeo and Aston Martin returning as title sponsors for Sauber and Red Bull respectively. Joining me to take you through all the action of the 2018 Formula One season is Anthony Davidson. Great to have you with us.
Thanks, Crofty. Always happy to be here. I'm looking forward to getting underway. Last year was Mercedes' fourth constructors' title in a row, although for the first half of the season, it was absolutely neck and neck with the Ferraris. Hopefully this year we can see the chase in pack take that final step, as I'd love to see a championship contest all the way up to the final race in Abu Dhabi. Another story to keep an eye on is the relative performance of McLaren and Toro Rosso, who have exchanged power unit suppliers this year. and given the additional restrictions on engine components, they need to be strong in terms of both performance and reliability.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The fence starts from pole position, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Hamilton, Sebastian Vettel, and Verstappen, Magnussen, and a Haas, Alonso, and Carlos Sainz, Van Dorn, Ocon, Nico Hülkenberg, and Perez, Gasly, Hartley, Charles Leclerc, and Marcus Ericsson, Stroll, and Sergei Sirotkin rounds off the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, we qualified higher than we were anticipating. Let's see if we can do just as well in the race.
What the hell?
this lap of the race. Keep this up. Clear. 7 seconds.
damage on the rear end. I don't know why they push me so much, you know. They cannot play bowling.
Right, sir, we've been looking at the damage, and we think you should be okay to continue. It'll cost us a little bit of time, but we're nearly at the end of the race.
Great effort there from Ferrari to take the victory today. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
So, here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari, on the top step once more. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Kimi Raikkonen takes the lead of the Drivers' Championship. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Probably Stoffel Vandoorne. You know, strong pace, good work with the strategy, just a very complete drive, I think.
On to the constructors then. Ferrari move to the top of the table. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us and goodbye until the next race.
we've received invitations to new historic events. You'll be able to choose whether or not to participate before the end of this weekend. Winning rivalries is a great way to earn respect from your team and around the paddock, which will help make it easier to negotiate favorable contracts. Your first rival is always your teammate, but you can choose who to declare as your second. The harder the rival from the eligible selection, the more respect you stand to gain or lose depending on the result.